G'day, I'm Victor Bray, and this is my tomato farm. Mmm, beautiful. I love tomatoes. In fact, the only thing I enjoy getting my teeth into more than tomatoes are donuts. Now, I know I probably look like a bit of a health nut, but I'm not. And while I wouldn't encourage anyone to smoke, I have been known to enjoy the occasional drag.
See yourself driving anything but a 57 Chevy?
No, I get asked that a little bit. Not really. I mean, I've been offered a lot of stuff over the years. You know, I could have done anything I wanted to do. Top fuel, alcohol, funny cars, and I've paid for some of them, but never raced one. Just like racing this year. I'm actually a street machine, a customizer kind of guy. The lead sleds and low riders and that sort of stuff. Problem is that I had a 57 Chevy street car and I kept putting bigger and bigger motor in it until it started hauling ass. And won a couple of events, realised I could do it, started doing it. People started paying me for doing it, and you know, we ended up getting some great sponsors, and we made a career out of it.
What is it about the 57?
It's just the shape of it, just iconic shape. I mean, the first time I seen a 57 Chevy, I went around to a mate of mine's place, Russell Peters. He said he bought this old Chevy. I would have been probably 18 years old, you know. I went around there, and he said, it's under the tarp in the backyard. So he said, pull it. It was just a little sprinkle a little bit. He had it under the tarp. I remember the day clearly. He pulled the side of the tarp up, and I saw the big chrome back fin on the car, the big chrome bump, and it's always sort of saw just that corner of the car, the chrome. But I threw the old thing back down, and I said, oh, thanks, mate. Off we went. So I wasn't even remotely interested in it. So off we went. I got halfway home, and I said, that bloody chrome looked all right, didn't it, you know? And when I bought a car from Wayne Barber, he's one of the local Chevy dealers over here, like US car deals in Australia. I bought it off him, he made all the promises in the world, and told me it was a great thing. It would have been in my early 20s probably, or maybe late teens, and the wheel fell off it on the first corner when I left his house. So I walked back up to his house again, and I said, hey Wayne, the wheel fell off that Chevy. And he said, oh, you can put it back on, can't you? And that was the end of the warranty. There was no warranty on it, so me and my mates knocked it back on there, drove it home. Comes and sees me, so I'll give you $600 back seeing the wheel fella. Put a set of wheels on, drove around the six cylinder, loved it. Loved it with a six cylinder. I love that car with a six cylinder as much as I love the door slammers today at 400 k's and 5 seconds. You know, I love 57 Chevys, and I love 57 Chevys, and I love 57 Chevys.